Hello, everyone, and welcome to this month's edition of Business Forum, brought to you by Cox Communications and the Greater Fort Walton Beach Area Chamber of Commerce. We often talk in our area about our economic engines, tourism obviously being one, and certainly our military friends and influence that they bring to our community. Let's talk today a little bit about the third economic engine, and that's our county government. I'm excited today to have two people with me who can answer all of our questions and give us additional information so that we better understand a lot of the processes that you and I interact with every day. Let me first introduce to you our latest commissioner, Carolyn Ketchel. And Carolyn, thank you for being here with us today.
Thank you. It's a pleasure to be here. I'm so grateful. Thank you very much for asking me to join you.
Good. Also today we have with us our county administrator, John Hofstad, who has worked with the county for many years. We're going to learn more about that in just a moment. Welcome, John.
Thank you for having me.
Good to have both of you here today. Commissioner Ketchel, if we may, let's just start with you and talk a little bit about some of the things that have come to the surface over these last few months that have been new and exciting for you. So tell us about what it's like to be a commissioner.
Well, I find it to be very interesting. As many people know, I was a social worker in this community for 40 years, off and on, not just 40 years here, but in my life. And many of the skills that I developed as a social worker are useful in public office. A lot of what I find of interest is, you know, constituent service. People want to, they want to be heard. They might have a problem with a road or another issue, a lights, you know, in their neighborhood or something, and they want you to solve it, and they want to be heard. And so a lot of what we do is constituent service, whether it's email or having people in the office, or trying to solve a neighborhood situation. The one thing that I've been very surprised about county government is how vast it is. It's in every aspect of our life. And luckily, we have five commissioners, and they give us various committee assignments, so we don't have to try to do everything. We have to know a little bit about each thing, but we really get entrenched in a few areas.
I understand. And we're going to talk more about that, but before we do, since you brought up the fact that your skill sets that you had fine-tuned over 40 years as a career clinical worker, also I believe that you were recently recognized as the Social Worker of the Year by the state of Florida. That's quite an award. That's not local or even regional, it's the whole state.
I've been very honored. The National Association of Social Workers starts regionally each year and picks a social worker. So I was selected for Northwest Florida, but I just received the recognition that I was recognized for the entire state of Florida by the National Association of Social Workers. To me, it's the honor of a lifetime after 40 years as a licensed clinical social worker. And I'm thrilled to receive it, and I'm proud to represent the profession. So I'm very excited about that.
Good for you. Well, we're so happy to have you as our commissioner. We know that you've certainly had to balance a lot of balls in the air over the years to get to where you are in your career path. Certainly being married to an active judge, Judge Ketchel, has certain requirements as from a spousal support standpoint. But you also, on top of that, raised two fine young men, one of whom's playing a little bit of ball now, as I understand.
Well, he did play Division I football for the University of South Florida. He was a tight end, wide receiver at that time. But now he is working for the Department of Environmental Protection in Tallahassee as the legislative director. Our other son, Micah, is in Washington, D.C., and he's very involved in Republican politics there. So we have a very politically active family, but I find that not to be unusual, because around our dinner table, that's what we discussed, was national politics and policy. And so many people in this community raise engineers, because at least one parent is an engineer. So that's sort of, they got it honestly.
Well, good for them. And John, let's move over to you for just a moment, sir. Tell us a little bit about your family. You're a local son, so we're happy to have you have come up through the community and attain the county administrator's role and the responsibilities associated with that. But let's hear a little bit more maybe about the Hofstad family.
Yeah, L.A., as you stated, yeah, I grew up here. My mother taught school in the Okaloosa County School District for 41 years and retired back in the early 2000s. And my father found his way to North Florida from northern Minnesota via the military, and retired here locally, and was a small business owner for several years, and product of the school system. You know, I started my school years at the old Fort Walton Beach Kindergarten, where the now school board offices are, and then Edwins, where my mother taught, and Bruner and Fort Walton Beach High School, and really all the way through college, and OW and University of West Florida, and then did some graduate work at Florida State University. So I am a proud native of Okaloosa County, and this January I will have reached 30 years of local government service. I started my career in the mid-80s with Mary Esther, of all places, and you know, I was a young 19-year-old that had no idea what I wanted to do with my life, and found an occupation that I enjoyed, and picked up some licenses along the way, and you know, and worked on my education and my educational goals, and served in a number of capacities, from an operations manager to utilities director and public works director, and ultimately where I'm at today is the county administrator. And I was able to transition into that role last year when our previous administrator, Ernie Padgett, retired, and served in that capacity in the interim for a few months, and then was fortunate that I was able to receive the support of the board and move into the position full-time and permanently. And it has been a very interesting change of pace for me, you know, where I've been narrowly focused in my career on the operational side of the house. Now you pick up the administrative duties of the job and you know, developing the budget that I'm sure we'll talk about here today. But I enjoy it. I will tell you, L.A., that I love going to work every morning, and there's a lot to be said for that. I enjoy the challenges of the job, and I will stay at it as long as they'll have me. So.
Well, we're certainly glad that you have that attitude, because we need you.
Well, thank you.
I also, if I remember correctly, you're currently living in the north end of the county, and even though so much of your work in the past and your youth was spent in the south end, you're also now a North County resident as well, and so you have a better understanding of the needs of the county there as well.
Yeah, I spent all of my youth and my earlier years and my adult years in the Fort Walton Beach area, and you know, I came to work for Okaloosa County back in early 2010 as a public works director, and my office as the public works director was in the north end of the county in the Crestview area. And so I drove back and forth every day from Fort Walton Beach to Crestview as part of my job. And about a little over a year ago, I decided I was going to be closer to my job in my office. And I moved to Baker, and I love it up there. I love that part of the county. But then, as fate would have it, you know, I moved into the administrator role. So now I'm driving north to south every day. But I do enjoy living in the north end of the county, and you know, still have my parents in the south end of the county, so if I want to get down this way and hang out with them, I can do that.
You still have a place to hang your
hat,
right?
That's right.
I understand. Well, Carolyn, let's just jump back to you for just a moment. Tell us a little bit about the number of committees that you're currently serving on. If I understand it correctly, each commissioner serves on certain committees so that they can better interact with the community and have an understanding of what the needs are.
That's true, and it gives us an opportunity to dig really deeply into the subject area. Before we go on to that, I just want to say that we're so thrilled with John Hofstede, and I just want to give a vote of confidence. I mean, he brings such a skill set and such a knowledge base, and it's wonderful to work with him. He's been a real asset to us. But back to the committees, yes, they asked me to be the liaison with Eglin and Hobart, which I find wonderful. I've been able to, for instance, see the base command change out at Eglin. That was very interesting. And I'm also on the airport committee, so I'm working, many of you have heard, trying to get a airport authority to sort of oversee the airport. And that's very interesting because we have a joint use facility, and I really enjoy learning about a lot of what it takes to run such a facility with Eglin Air Force Base. And it's been very interesting working with Sunil Harmon, our airport director. Also, I'm on the Tourist Development Committee, and that's been challenging to learn. That's not really my area of expertise, to learn about tourism, but it's been interesting because we have a fabulous team headed up by Ed Schroeder and his team who understand about marketing and bringing more business into our area. And we've just finished the most phenomenal year. And it really, a lot of it had to do with, I think, the BP oil spill putting us on the map. People have discovered us. It used to be that we were just, you know, the sort of the destination of the people who lived in the Southeast. Now we're getting people from all over, and we're about ready to launch a campaign to bring people from Chicago. So, and hopefully we'll get a direct flight. That's another thing we're working on. I'm also working on the transportation, the coordinated transportation. As you know, LA, in your work with Horizons, there are many people in this community that depend very much on transportation: the blind, disabled, the aged, the working poor, those who have no other way to get around. And we must find, that is one area we must find. There's a lot of misconceptions about transportation out there. We do put a little bit of money into it, about $200,000 a year, and John could talk about that. But a lot of it is federally matched and state matched. So we have to put a little bit of skin in the game. But the dividends are so good because a lot of people could not afford to, for instance, live in Destin, but they live in Crestview, and then they take transportation down to Destin to clean the hotel rooms, to be service staff, and so forth. So I'm very excited to be a part of that committee as well. So that kind of gives you an overview of some of the things I'm working on.
You sound like a very busy lady right off the bat. That's the first thing I would take from that conversation.
I think all of us are. I think all the commissioners are very busy.
Yeah, I understand that. Certainly, I can see where a lot of your committees are tied together, and so it makes good sense to have, you know, that sync with you being involved in all of them, the TDC in conjunction with the airport, the joint use with the military, and,
yes,
you know, and servicing our military and that type of thing. So. I'm quite confident that it keeps you hopping every day.
And as you know, I'm also the liaison with the Fort Walton Beach Chamber. One of the things I had to mention is that each commissioner basically takes a chamber and works with them. So I was fortunate enough to get Fort Walton Beach, which makes sense since I'm from the South End District. And I very much enjoy the work with you and with Ted Corcoran and the staff there. They do a fabulous job.
Oh, well, thank you very much. We appreciate you saying that. Certainly, we're very proud of our Chamber of Commerce and the things that we're able to contribute to the community, and it's important to have folks such as yourself as a liaison to that board of directors so that the communications are high between the county and the Chamber of Commerce itself to ensure that we are able to move forward. And ladies and gentlemen, we're currently at that point where we're going to take a little break, and as soon as we come back, we're going to learn a lot more about the budgetary process of our county. And you're going to be excited about some of the things that you hear. We'll be right back.
So who's going to do what?
I'll pack the dead batteries.
Great.
I'll only put what I don't need into a duffel bag.
Perfect. That's totally unhelpful.
No problem.
Meanwhile, I will try to comfort everyone by speaking in a calm voice.
And who is going to handle supplies?
I can forget to do a list for us.
Thanks, pal.
We couldn't be any less prepared. I'm proud of you guys.
Talk to your kids about who to call, where to meet, what to pack. Visit ready.gov/kids for tips and information.
As a business owner, you know you need to stand out, highlighting what makes you unique. Cox Media understands that. So when it's time to get creative, to match message to image, where do you start? The Cox Media Creative Department helps translate your business strategy into creative strategy. Words, pictures, the whole show. We do compelling campaigns for video, the web, even video on the web. Be heard and be remembered. Let Cox Media customize a creative campaign for you.
Hello, and welcome back to Business Forum, sponsored by Cox Communications and the Fort Walton Beach Area Chamber of Commerce. Today we have with us Commissioner Carolyn Ketchel and County Administrator John Hofstad. And John, we were speaking a little bit earlier about the budget. I know that that's coming upon us, and you've been working diligently on that. What would you like to share with our viewers today about the county budget process, and the things that they should be looking at so that they can better understand where their tax dollars are going.
Absolutely, and I'll tell you, it's not coming upon us, it's upon us. And we've been in the middle of developing our budget on the staff level, and that's behind the scenes work that we do with the administrator's office and our various department heads and our constitutional officers in developing the budget proposal that we'll present to the board and to the citizens. So I will tell you that that work has been in progress now for about 6 weeks. And the way it works is just like it works at your home. You have X amount of dollars coming in, and you have Y amount of expenses going out, and you have to balance the two. And we have needs in this county. There's no doubt about it. And I know my counties to the east and west, and our counterparts throughout the state have competing needs just like we do. It's how you balance the dollars that are available against those needs. And I will tell you, our department heads do an outstanding job of developing their budgets and speaking to what the needs are in their respective departments. And at the end of the day, it's my job to determine what's needed, what we need to fund, and make that presentation to the board. And ultimately, the board as a legislative body will decide what that spending plan is going forward. But in this county, you have a budget that's roughly $300 million, and that covers all of the needs within the BCC. It's multiple funds. You have your property tax component that funds your general fund side of the house, which is some of your BCC functions, the Board of County Commissioners, and that's the funding that's also used to balance the budgets of our constitutional officers and the sheriff. The sheriff's budget depends on property taxes, your supervisor of election, property appraiser, and so on and so forth. And at the end of the day, again, it's about prioritizing all of those needs and deciding what your spending plan is going to be going forward. This year, we're looking at roughly 4.5% increase in property value. So that's going to generate some additional revenue for us. And then we have a state shared revenue component. We're not an income, personal income tax state here in Florida, and Florida survives for the most part on sales tax, and a portion of that sales tax is distributed to the 67 counties here in Florida. So that makes up a component of our annual revenue as well. So we're looking at somewhere in the neighborhood of about $3 million additional dollars to go around for all of the competing needs we have. I've met with the sheriff on a number of occasions, and I understand his dilemma. And how do you address the ongoing law enforcement needs of this county? And law enforcement's a priority in Okaloosa County. We recognize that. Law enforcement and public safety are at the top of the pyramid, and we have to fund that. But again, we have a small incremental increase in dollars coming into this county that we have to weigh against all the competing priorities we have. So, you start at that point, and then through a process of several weeks, we hone that down to where we get a balanced budget that we present to the board, and we'll start that process next week. Next Wednesday starts our budget workshops, which we host a number of workshops, five or six workshops over about a 3 or 4 week period. And that's when the board will hear from myself, the individual department heads, and our constitutional officers as to what their needs are and what their needs are going forward. I'll tell you, LA, as is the case most years, there are expenses that are beyond our control. There are expenses that I can't regulate as the county administrator. And for example, the state of Florida agreed to Medicaid expansion this year, the legislature did. There were about 16 disproportionately affected counties of the 67 in the state of Florida, above and beyond the 3% that we were hoping to cap through the legislature. The 3% increase across the board with the 67 counties, couldn't reach an agreement with that. So we're one of those disproportionately affected counties. Our impact as it relates to Medicaid is 16%, above and beyond what it was last year. To equate that in terms of dollars, that's a $250,000 increase to our budget. It's beyond our control. We have DJJ legislation and the clawback provision that was approved by the legislature. And, that's an additional expense to us that we haven't programmed in years past, and almost a $500,000 expense inmate health care. As you know, in Okaloosa County, the county BCC manages the jail here for Okaloosa County, and we have certain cost escalators that are built into those contracts that are beyond our control, and one of those contracts is inmate health care. That's a $200,000 increase we're having to program into our budget this year that we didn't have last year. Property insurance is another one. Property insurance is going up. That's a $180,000 additional expense. So you see how all this adds up. So now all of a sudden that $3 million in additional funding, when you have to back out $1.2 million in expenses beyond your control, that's that much less money to go around. So it's a, it is a comprehensive exercise. I'll put it to you that way.
I can imagine that it would be, in so much as even with the increase in taxes, you're only experiencing a 1% increase in your budget. And then of that 1% increase that you're experiencing, 40% or so of that is being utilized by uncontrollable costs that are driven outside the realm of the county's power to control. So that must make it very a very daunting task. And I'm certainly glad that it's you sitting in that chair right now and not me being responsible for a $300 million budget. I take my hat off to you to be able to balance all the needs of the county and all the needs of all the constitutional officers. I can only imagine how that would feel on a day-to-day basis, but certainly thank you for stating that our safety is a priority. I appreciate that. I think that everybody agrees with you on that one as well. Commissioner, do you have some things that you could add from your perspective on the budget and where we're going with that?
Yes, I do think so. I understand, you know, John is working very hard to put the pieces together, and it is a very difficult exercise, but it's no more difficult than all of us struggle with in our day-to-day budget. And I mean, it is a large, $300 million. When I ask people that in forums, how large do you think our budget is? People are very surprised to hear that we have a $300 million budget. However, I think part of why we're elected is to hold it back, to make hard decisions. And we've been very blessed in this county that we are receiving some BP funding, and that helps a lot to augment and offset some of the expenses so that we don't have to consider raising taxes this year. And in addition, some of the money that we do get, I don't think we should necessarily throw into general revenue, but we ought to consider rebuilding our reserve funds. We have depleted those, and our chairman has recognized that and has said he's committed to also rebuilding that. And some of the things, some of the desires and wants that we hope to get, for instance, the Crestview Courthouse. It is in very bad shape. Anybody that's been in it can see the security issues and some of the problems with that very old facility. It may take us a number of years to get that financing and to get that all put together with the state legislature. They didn't come through with it this year. But I think that we need to set our priorities and work slowly towards that. On the flip side, we are going into a beautiful new facility in Shalimar, and that's going to be kind of a one-stop government shopping, which is going to be very nice. You'll be able to go to your tax collector, your property appraiser, stop in and see your county commissioner. So I'm very excited about that, and it's going to be a very nice facility, and it will save money for the taxpayer over the long run because we will no longer be paying rent in a lot of locations.
Yeah, so there was a lot of conversation about the Shalimar courthouse and that renovation and how it was going to apply to the county budget, but I think it's clear to everybody at this point that the long-term effect of that that investment by our county commissioners is going to have a very positive impact, so we thank you for doing that. I also know that transportation is a passion of yours, and you spoke briefly about it earlier where the public transportation was concerned, but I didn't know if you might want to expand on that just a little bit.
Basically, I think it's very important that we recognize that people need a way to get around. We have a large county that's divided geographically, and that makes it difficult. But we have been looking at how to piece that together with different services, and I have a feeling that this is going to be a very positive year. We heard loud and clear from the citizens last year. They filled the hall. And they ask us to continue to try to keep public transportation in place. We've gone to the municipalities, we've been working behind the scenes, we have a group that's been meeting with representatives from each of the municipalities to try to work out a solution. And I feel when we unveil that, people are going to be very pleased.
Good for you. Well, we appreciate the hard work that you're doing on those types of problems that we have in the county. It's very much appreciated. Excuse me. And John, when the budget is put together, what is the timeline on that? When will we have a budget that's approved and in place?
We'll start our series of budget workshops next Wednesday. So our first series of budget discussions will start Wednesday. I believe that meeting is scheduled for 8:30 a.m. at the Water and Sewer Building in the commission chambers there in that building. And the way the format is set up, we'll have the various departments and department heads and some of their division managers that'll make presentations to the board. For instance, like in the case of Public Works has multiple divisions. There are half a dozen divisions inside Public Works, and each of those divisions has a divisional budget. So the department head along with their assistants will make those individual presentations to the board members. Wednesday I will kick off the budget discussion, and I will provide an overview of where we are at this point, the balanced budget that's before the board, and then through these budget deliberations over the next 3 weeks, the board will decide, is this a plan that they support collectively, or is there changes they would like to see incorporated into that budget? The commissioners might see some capital construction projects that I've had to eliminate to balance the budget that they would prefer to have in that budget, and they'll have that opportunity. Then we'll roll into September, and the two budget hearings in September, about the second week in September, we'll put the final touches on the budget.
Excellent. Well, we certainly appreciate the hard work that both our county commissioners and our staff do to make our lives better where this is concerned. I'd like to thank each one of you for taking time out of your busy days and schedules to be here today to share with our viewers a little bit about some of the inner workings of our county and how important that is. And I'll just close by saying, ladies and gentlemen, our county government is our third economic engine. We appreciate you being here and visiting with us today. We hope you've enjoyed the show, and we're going to all look forward to seeing you next month.